That is amazing.
You all right? I'll tell you a little bit about myself. I'm a Baptist minister, actually. Most people don't know what that is, I have to explain. It's a bit like being a vicar or a priest, but I don't wear frocks. As long as we don't count Tuesdays, because that's my day off, I can do what I want. And me and my wife are the same cup size, so that comes in handy. I'm married. I've been married for 30 years, over 30 years now. Thank you. We all know what it means. It just means my love life has become a bit like my bank card. Contactless. There are other similarities I don't like to talk about. The fact that I don't have to worry about pressing any buttons. Transactions are quicker than they used to be. And I'm constantly getting declined, so.
Very good.
It wasn't that way in the beginning. Oh no, it was all welcome gifts, high interest, and instant access. Now it's flat rate, no interest, and I need 3 to 5 days clearance, to be fair. And I had to train to be a minister of a church. Can't just turn up, I had to train. I'm still on probation, to be honest. But that's kind of cool where I live, so that's all right. Sometimes I take my watch off, put it around my ankle, cover it with my sock, just to get in character. With all that training, you think I'd be good at my job, wouldn't you? I'm not. I'm really not. You know, because they don't teach you what you need to do. You know what they taught me? Hebrew and Greek.
Greek?
I'm from Bootle, right? Seriously, the only Greek I know is Stavros does me kebabs, right? And Hebrew's when a guy puts the kettle on. Good night and God bless.
Happy day.
listen to the fat cats, they only want their cream. Always needing oil for feeding their machines.
We must care about the animals, care about the trees.
I'll need help from you.
You get help from me.
Oh.
How nice is this?
From?
I'm from Devon originally, but I live in London.
Amazing. Okay. And you are going to be singing?
I am indeed.
Is that how you make a living?
Not at all. I'm a paediatric nurse. I work at a big children's hospital here in London.
Do you ever take your guitar to work?
I do, yeah. When I was a student, there was a boy who wanted to learn guitar, but he had nobody to teach him, so I said, oh, I can teach you. And then as I'd play with him, other parents would say, can you come into my kids' room and play? So I'd end up just going around the wards, just playing for the kids.
That's so cool. What an amazing thing to be able to bring a smile to all those faces.
It made me think, maybe I should give the whole music thing a go, so this is why I'm here today.
And Beth, are you going to sing a cover or an original song?
I'm singing an original song.
Good.
It's a difficult job, and part of processing a lot of the things that happen on the ward, I write songs. So the song I've written today is about what I've learned from my patients and their families. I'm not a parent myself, but I've got a snapshot of what it's like to love a child. So that's what inspired this song.
Good for you. Take a deep breath. Let's make the next 2 minutes count.
Okay. So this is called You Taught Me What Love Is.
You will never know how much I love you. And oh, you had to go, but I'm always thinking about you. If I could take your place, I'd do it a thousand times. Now there's a U-shaped hole in my life. And no, I won't be the same. You taught me to be brave, and although just less than a year, I never slept at all. And I'll never sleep again if I could see you once more. You were too good for this world, this life. You were handpicked for paradise. And no, I won't be the same. You taught me to be brave, and although it wasn't for long, you will never. never know how much I love you.
Do it puts everything into perspective. And I just was thinking about my own children. I was choked up the whole time. Yeah. It was so beautiful. I think you're really, really special.
Once in a lullaby.
We say on this show you've got 2 minutes to change your life, and I think you've changed your life, but also, you know, you've touched all our lives too with that song. It was truly staggeringly beautiful, and you delivered it perfectly. Well
done. Thank you very much. Thanks.
You have such a difficult job. I don't know where you find the strength. Totally admire you for doing that selflessly every single day, but to also have this kind of talent is God-given, so you literally are an angel in every way, and I'm sure loads of parents at that hospital agree.
Beautiful song. Absolutely beautiful song.
Thank you.
The lyric is so poignant. You're a great singer, you're a great songwriter, you're a great person, so you just tick 3 boxes. Well done.
Thank you very much.
So, we'll take a vote.
I need to go first. I want to say yes.
Okay, good. It's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
4 yeses. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Well done.
Well done, thank you.
I always say nurses are walking angels.
I was just thinking, in a way, you just don't want her to leave that ward, though, do you?
I know.
Because she must spread so much joy on the ward.
It was amazing. That's so moving.
Very special audition, that.
Well done.
Thrilled for you.
Go and celebrate.
All right, will do.
Congratulations.
Well done, Beth.
Thank you very much.
Now, my dog's called Miracle. And today, we're hoping to show you a real miracle. Okay, where you go?
Hello.
You go?
Hello.
Okay. There we are. Now, Simon, I know that you love dogs.
Yeah.
So, in front of you are 40 of my dogs that are back home.
You've got 40?
I have over 40. I would like you to cut those photos into 4 roughly equal piles.
Okay. One. Mm-hmm.
Now, I want you to take one from each pile from the top. Don't show me. Keep one for yourself and pass 3 to Amanda. Just don't show me. And Amanda, if you can do the same. You keep one, pass that to David as well. Now, there's no possible way I could know which cards you've chosen. Okay? So you can see that they are all completely individual. Okay? Now, you may wonder why I have those 40 dogs. This is going to explain the story.
You with the sad eyes, don't be discouraged.
Oh my God.
Lies. It's hard to tell. take courage in a world full of people. You can lose sight of it all. Darkness inside you can make you feel so small. But I see your true colors shining through. I see your true colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let them show your true colors, true colors, beautiful. If this world makes you crazy, take all you can bear. You call me up, 'cause you know I'll be there. And I see your truth.
I have no idea which photos you chose, but Miracle did. And here's something that we filmed earlier today.
Right, Miracle, we've only got room to take four dogs to go and meet the Britain's Got Talent judges. So who's it going to be? Who do you want to take? Tell me. Good boy. David, can I ask you to hold up the photo that you have and call out the name of the dog?
Braveheart.
Marilyn Monroe.
Grace Kelly.
Jean Harlow.
Obviously, I couldn't bring 40 that are there, but Miracle decided to choose four, so I'm going to let you meet them.
What is the name of your crew?
House of Swag Kids.
Where are you guys from?
Ireland.
Ooh.
Ireland, yes. So who's the youngest? And how old are you?
Six.
And what's your name?
Madison.
Madison. So what makes you different from the other dance crews we've had on Britain's Got Talent?
So we have a message, basically positive mental health.
Wow. A very, very powerful message. Is there a particular reason that you've taken on this issue?
Some of us have gone through a lot with mental health, so it's just an easy way to let it all out when you can't find the words.
Okay, good for you. Brilliant.
We're a dance guild with a big message. We promote positive mental health through performing arts. This is such a big topic. Everybody in the group has been touched by it. You could be so down in the dumps, and then other days you could be so happy. It's so hard to talk about it, but dancing about it makes everything so much easier.
You always feel like free, and if you have anything on your mind, like you can talk, like the way we do our circles, where we just talk about our problems.
And like how we write
whatever troubles on our hands when we dance.
We're going to show everybody that it's okay not to be okay, isn't it?
Being on Britain's Got Talent is a really huge thing for us. Honestly, just amazing.
Well, look. We are all excited to see what you guys are going to do. So, the stage is yours.
Thank you. It's not that I don't want to be happy. No matter how hard I try, I can't bring myself to be happy. I just want to scream for help. I feel so alone and so ashamed. Everyone says I'm too young to be feeling this way. I feel scared and alone. Why do I have to be this way?
There was a time I was alone. Nowhere to go and no place to call home. My only friend was the man in the moon. And even sometimes he would go away to run, run, lost boy. They say to me, lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free.
Billy.
What do you want from me? Why don't you run from me? What are you wondering? What do you know?
Come here.
I wanna end me.
Nobody likes you. Everyone hates you.
You are horrible.
You can't do anything.
I wanna end me. What do you want from me? Why don't you run from me? What are you wondering? What do you know?
Sometimes I feel like my head's up in the air. I know I can count on you. Sometimes I feel like saying, Lord, I just don't care. But you've got the love I need to see me through.
To talk to each other.
There's people out there who will listen.
Together we can make a change.
This is an issue that people find very difficult to talk about, and how wonderful to bring it to the stage here today, and so brilliant to see it in the medium of dance.
Yeah.
This is amazing. You know, you're shedding light on something very difficult, and of course, let's not forget, you're brilliantly talented dancers.
There was a lot of flavour in there, and I love the way you put the whole thing together with yourself, young man, being at the front, telling the story. Fantastic audition. Well done.
Children listen to children. It's a very strong message here, and I can see a lot of potential.
You told the story really, really cleverly.
Yeah.
What we're seeing this year is younger people coming on and actually educating us, which is amazing. Because you've got the passion, right?
David?
Let me start this off with a yes.
I'm saying yes.
It's a yes from me.
Okay, House of Swag. You now got four yeses.
Here we go.
audience. They're a lovely bunch. You like them a lot.
This is where we go.
You got it. OK.
Oh, my God.
Hello.
Hi.
Welcome to Britain's Got Talent.
Thank you.
What's your name?
My name is Serene.
How old are you?
I'm 14.
14?
Yes.
And whereabouts are you from?
I'm from London.
Okay. Have you told your friends at school you're here today?
No, they have no idea I'm here.
Right, okay. So who's here with you today?
My grandfather, my two aunties, my uncle, my cousin, my brother, and my parents.
A nice mix.
Goodness me. It's the entire audience.
It is the entire audience.
Yes.
I like that. Is there anything else you want to tell us about you, yourself?
So I guess it's pretty obvious that I can't see. There was a time where I could, and now I can't. But I guess music is my vision, and that's just what I live by, and music is my thing.
Good for you. Well, we're all rooting for you, and I know everyone at home is going to be rooting for you too. So in your own time, Serene.
Thank you.
I was here.
Yes.
That was good. Well done. Okay. There you are. There you go. Good luck, Serene. Good luck, Serene.
What you couldn't see was the whole of the Palladium on their feet applauding you because they love you. Alicia.
Oh, what a sweet, sweet girl you are. My heart is just melted.
Thank you.
You're so nervous, but that's completely understandable. It's a massive deal. It's a massive stage. and you sang beautifully.
I just found the entire audition so poignant. You're just so beautiful and vivacious. You kind of just exude lightness.
Oh my gosh,
it was,
thank you.
It was just brilliant.
Thank you.
Serene, were you nervous because you thought you're going to get bad comments? Have people criticised you in the past?
I only do school performances, so this is something completely new. And being able to sing right now is just such a big opportunity, and I don't want to waste it.
Good for you. I think I should be the first person to say yes.
It's a yes from me. It's a yes from me.
And it's a yes from me. Well done, Serene.
Yes.
Well, I could hope.
That was really good. Absolutely fantastic.
Hi.
Please introduce yourselves.
So I'm Jade, and what's your name? Christian. Christian is my little brother, and we're signing along with us.
How old are you?
I'm 18 years old, and how old are you, Christian?
Four.
He's four.
Four, yeah. My goodness me. Fantastic. What are you going to do for us today?
So we're here to do some sign language and some singing.
Brilliant.
Thank you. We were told that Christian would never be able to communicate. I taught him sign language so then he could talk, and he's here, a little miracle, proving everybody wrong.
Yes, sister! That's what she's supposed to do!
I didn't want to accept that Christian would never be able to communicate. I just knew that there was a voice in there that needed to come out.
Exciting, isn't it?
No.
You're so cheeky, cheeky.
We decided we wanted to teach other people this, so we started a class. We're just amazed by how many people wanted to get involved.
I'm Taylor and I'm 7.
I'm Sam, I'm 22.
I'm Ella and I'm 12.
Are you excited to see Sam and Cal?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm in love with him anyway.
Ella has actually met Simon before. She won a Child of Courage Award at the Pride of Britain 2019.
You are the sweetest, bravest little girl, and you deserve this. Congratulations.
Thank you. Now, I can't believe I'm on Bitter Cut Talent. It's amazing. It's made my dream come true.
Just gonna go out there and show them what we've got, aren't
we? Yeah.
Try our best.
Amazing.
Yes. We would never normally get an opportunity to do something like this. It's unbelievable. We're just so excited.
We wish you all the best.
Say thank you.
Don't make me melt.
Such an anthem for people who maybe don't feel part of the world or part of anything. And I just found it really, really moving.
Thank
you. It was absolutely brilliant.
Hello, thank you.
Gla-gla.
Thank you.
I genuinely can't find the words.
Amazing!
There you go.
Thank you.
And Christian, you are an absolute little star, so thank you.
Hey, thank you.
Gargle!
I have to confess, I have a friend of mine in this choir. Ella. We met at the Pride of Britain, and I heard Ella sing, and I said, I have a feeling one day you're going to be auditioning on one of our shows, and guess what? You're here. And you're saying, this is me, and I'm thinking, you are us, because you define what this show should be all about. This is an audition I will never, ever forget.
Thank you. I promise you I'll keep
you safe. Every one of you gave everything to this performance, an amazing positive message to put out there, and all I can say is...
Amazing. Well done.